Hey guys, welcome to Practicle.sg. Today, we'll be learning how to draw a model to help us visualize and solve before and after questions. This type of question usually has some quantities at the start, and then something happens. And then at the end, there's a different set of quantities. The question usually asks us to find something either at the start or at the end of the question. Let us look at an example. Ash and Pika had an equal number of Pokeballs at the start. Ash then used 78 Pokeballs to catch some Pokemons, while Pika used 196 Pokeballs. Then, after this, Ash had twice as many Pokeballs left as Pika. How many Pokeballs did each of them have at first? As I mentioned earlier, this question deals with quantities at different times. For example, at the start, Ash and Pika had an equal number of Pokeballs. And then later, something happens. And then at the end, Ash had twice as many Pokeballs left as Pika. It may look confusing at first, but it is actually very easy to draw a model based on this question. There are two ways to do it. We can either go forward in time from the start to the end, or we can do it in the inverse order from the end to the start. For example, if we use the first way, we'll first look at how Ash and Pika had an equal number of Pokeballs, followed by what they did to the Pokeballs, and then followed by how many Pokeballs they have left. Alternatively, we can work with the models in inverse order. First of all, we'll look at how Ash had twice as many Pokeballs as Pika. And then we'll work with how many Pokeballs that they each used. Finally, then we'll look at how they had an equal number of Pokeballs. The question then is, which method do we use? If you look at the question more closely, you'll realize that we are trying to find how many Pokeballs did each of them have at first. Therefore, we should be using the second method and work from the back to the front. Let's start to draw the models. We know that at the end, Ash had twice as many Pokeballs left as Pika. Therefore, we can draw two boxes for Ash and then one box for Pika. Remember that before this, Ash and Pika both had more Pokeballs. Ash used 78 Pokeballs to catch some Pokemons, while Pika used 196. So we must also remember to draw this in. When we draw these two parts, we don't actually know how long each part should be, but it is okay. When we go to the first part, where we know that Ash and Pika had an equal number of Pokeballs at the start, this will be the point where we know that actually both of them must be the same length. So you can edit it so that they look like the same. Now, things become quite clear. We now know that 1 unit plus 1 unit plus 78 is equal to 1 unit plus 196. Therefore, actually 1 unit plus 78 is equal to 196. And then we can write it down. We know that 1 unit is actually equal to 196 minus 78. From here, we can do a calculation and know that 1 unit is equal to 118. If we know that 1 unit is equal to 118, then we can actually find how many Pokeballs Pika had at the start, which is equal to 1 unit plus 196. Therefore, each of them had 118 plus 196 Pokeballs, which is equal to 314. And there we have our answer. But is it really correct? We should always do a quick check. Since we found that Pika had 314, and we know that Ash and Pika had the same number of Pokeballs, we can actually do a quick check for Ash instead. From our model, we can see that Ash has 2 units plus 78 Pokeballs. So we simply write it down, and Ash has 118 plus 118 plus 78 Pokeballs. And if you do a calculation, you realize that it's actually the same number, which is 314. That means we got the correct answer. I hope you have learned something new today. To test yourself, try to do this question again without watching the video. Alternatively, you can also join us at practicle.sg and do more interesting questions like this. See ya!